giving you the access for it. Navin, can you make me the presenter? Show my screen. Yes. I think people are able to see my screen, right?
Yeah, now I can able to.
Okay. See, this environment, health and safety. Safety talks about the safety aspects or the hygienic aspects of a premises, plant premises. So basically, it's something to do with your what are the standard operating procedure, what are the types of training that employee has to undergo. See, here we are moving it to a scenario where it can be manufacturing, it can be a utility company which produces or manufactures power, it can be a construction industry, it can be any industry like a maritime industry or a oil and gas industry or a offshore drilling industry. It can be any industry. Even the normal industry like IT industry where employee works also needs to take care of the industrial hygiene and safety aspects of an employee. So when we say that, what are the different safety aspects of the employee that are to be taken care of? See, basically there is a regulation called as OSHA regulation or OSHA standards. And there is something called as ISO 18001 standards, which certifies an organization to be compliant if it follows certain precautions or certain regulations when an employee is working in a premises. For example, a construction industry is there. A person who is working there should wear a helmet, a rubber shoe, along with gloves so that he is not injured. This is called as a personal protective equipment, and if a person is not wearing that, that's a non-conformity or non-compliance according to the regulation, and a company can be fined. So how to make sure it doesn't happen for our organization? We need to have a system in place. That system should give an information as what precautions should be taken in a particular area of work or particular work area, and then what are the risks that are present in a work area. Suppose if a person is working in an industry, construction industry, the risk is he might fall down if he is working on a height, or something might fall on his head if he is working at the lower level. So these are the different risks associated and how you are going to mitigate that risk based on certain safety measures. This is the activity that is performed in the industry which we have to map in SAP and give it to the organization. See, SAP is a business application software. I believe the other person is also from SAP background, right? Okay, no problem. So, see the, what to say that, since SAP is a business application software, it integrates various modules. The integration happens with all the other modules also. So here we are talking about 6 separate modules. It will be under logistics, EHS. Till now I have explained about industrial hygiene and safety, where the safety of the employee or the hygiene of the workplace or work area is taken into consideration. Now we are talking about health. In spite of taking all the precautions also, if some injury happens or because of working in a premises, negative impact on the health, like hearing problem, breathing problems, or some kind of allergies, high blood pressure. This kind of problem comes, what are the remedial measures that are to be taken, or what are the proactive measures that are to be taken to see that the employee or the person who is present in a work area is not impacted further of his health. These are the regulations which are handled in both of the modules, occupational health and industrial hygiene and safety. The next module comes about waste management, where it mainly talks about different kinds of waste generated. Those waste can be hazardous waste or non-hazardous waste. Non-hazardous waste means like the organic waste that is generated in the cafeteria, or the stationary waste like paper, pencil. All these kind of things are the non-hazardous waste. Hazardous waste like tins, chemical tins, or chemicals which are used, expired chemicals, materials, these are all hazardous waste. How you are disposing this waste without affecting the environment, again there are certain regulations are present, like RoHS regulation, V regulation are present. So how you are going to manage it shows you. The next is dangerous goods management and hazardous substance management. How you are handling a chemical along with the, means like how you are handling, means whenever a chemical enters a premises, let us think from a functional perspective. When a chemical enters a premises, it basically what to say, there is some a document called as MSDS, Material Safety Data Sheet, which comes, say for example you buy a say anything like a player, a DVD player or a television, whatever it is, you will be given a pamphlet or a document which shows that there are some safety precautions that are to be taken. If you don't take the safety precautions, what will happen? The product can damage, or the person, you who are handling the product, can get the damage. Similarly, when a chemical is coming also, there is something called as a MSDS which will come. So this MSDS contains every information what a person or an organization has to follow when you are handling a material which is coming inside a premises. So your dangerous goods management, hazardous substance management and product safety deals with that. And there are a lot of integrations. Hazardous substance management talks about storage of materials, how safely we can store the materials, or reporting of the metals according to SARA, CERCLA Act. Dangerous goods management talks about transport of materials, and when you are transporting, whether it's in a sales scenario or a purchasing scenario, how safely the material has to be transported without affecting the environment. It's not like that you are transporting a, say for example, you are transporting a, say fuel, petrol, crude oil, whatever it is, and it keeps on spilling, so environment get damaged. It should not be the case. So how safe you are doing that, and all these activities are covered by different regulations, and for that you need a system, and that system is SAP EHS. This will be used for compliance reporting. This will be used for many other activities. Hello?
Yeah.
Hello?
Yeah.
Hello, is everyone there? Is everyone there online?
Yeah.
Yeah, thank you. So, yes, this is a brief overview about SAP EHS module. So, if there are any questions like within this topic, maybe just let me know.
So, what are the other modules are integrated with EHS?
The other modules that are integrated with EHS is like PM, FI, MM. Mainly it is basically MM, PM, HR, and then you are having other integrations with FI, document management system, classification system. You are having integration with other areas of QM also, if possible.
So will you be going to see the integration part also for each and every module?
Sorry, I couldn't get your question. Can you please repeat it?
Yeah, will you see the integration parts of the integration?
Yeah, absolutely right. That is part of EHS, because without integration there is no EHS. EHS cannot work as a standalone. If you are going for a portal based solution, you need to have your own data, or you need to have integrated data. So definitely without integration EHS is not possible to proceed further.
And I have another one more question. This is also same like if I learn this EHS, the roles and responsibilities are also similar like other function consultants, right?
Yeah, it will be similar to other functional consultants, but EHS, as I told you initially, it's a peculiar module. It is depending, see for example, if I say like I worked in SD module or MM module, they will say like according to my client business process, this is what I have followed. But EHS is not like that. it is not a client business process, it's an industry business process. Say for example, as I'm telling, it's a utility industry, chemical, construction, pharmaceutical, whatever it is. It's an industry-wise approach, and that approach is determined by regulation. So if I'm in a construction industry or a pharmaceutical industry, I have to follow the regulation stated by OSHA, which is standard across all the states or all the countries where it is being followed across that industry. For example, you go to a pharmaceutical industry, you have to wear the complete protective equipment when you are working with certain chemicals. So you work in Pfizer, you work in Merck, you work in Ranbaxy, whatever the country or whatever the company, if you are following the standard ISO 18001 standard, you have to wear the complete mask and gown. So here the role will be a bit different, saying that across the industries, if I follow a regulation, the same regulation, it will be the same, which is missing in other models. But yes, the responsibilities and the roles will be same as you are doing it for other models.
So even EHS also, we are going to develop some kind of a reports, interfaces and everything, right?
Even EHS module?
As a function consultant, we will going to develop a report. We will going to create a functional specification for the report and interface.
See, here the reporting is, we are having a concept called as WWI, where Windows Word is integrated with SAP, generate a compliance report or MSDS or TREM cards and or labels and give it to the client. That is one way of doing it. That will be done by functional consultant. The second way of reporting is that the normal R3 reporting using the smart forms. The third option is that you can integrate business intelligence and generate a BA reports for statistical purpose. The fourth option is that you can integrate Excelsius or business objects and get the report to suit that requirement. So whatever it is, the integration is available. It entirely depends on what kind of reports the regulation is needing, or what kind of reports the client is willing to have or submit to the authorities.
So, as part of training, what we are going to see in this?
What will be the?
What are the things we are going to see in this? Means reporting, WWI integration?
Yeah, reporting definitely. WWI is part of it because functional consultant is the one who is to do it. So, WWI is something where you definitely see it and work on it. Okay. But normal R3 reporting, as I told you, this is purely functional training. So normal R3 reporting or normal ABAP reporting, that will be taken care by a technical consultant. So definitely that cannot be shown.
And including WWI and BA integration, right?
WWI and?
BI integration.
No, BA is entirely different module, right? I will show you the location where the integration will happen or can happen, but I cannot show you because we are not having the integrated BA server. In the IDAS, we don't have integrated BA server. See, whatever is possible from a functional perspective will be shown. Whatever depth you want, whatever level it is needed from a functional perspective will be shown, because this is purely a functional training. Coding and all, or developing a new reports and all, or using ABAP programming, or using a BA, or using business objects or Excelsius, definitely that cannot be shown because that's purely technical. And even in the project where we are working also, since we are functional consultants, we are having a technical team who will develop it based on the inputs given by us or the format given by us. Except WWI, that should be done by functional consultant, hence we'll be doing it.
So even in the previous projector also, actually we got developed some kind of a smartphones and web teams application. That where we can log the incident, and there we can give the printout for the reporting purpose to HSP.
Okay.
There are four kind of reports are there, dangerous goods, hazardous, injuries, incident, something is there.
No, that's what I'm telling. See, if it's a WWI report, I will show you. See, Ravi, that's what I'm telling. If it's a WWA report, definitely it will be shown because that's the activity of functional consultant. But if you're talking about a report like a SARA report or a chemical inventory report or some kind of list of persons report and all, which is above reporting, I will show you the report, but I cannot show you how to configure the report. The reason is that will be done through a program, right?
Yeah.
Showing a report or functionality of the report, that's not a big problem because we can generate a standard report in SAP and we can show it. This is how the report will be coming based on the data that you are maintaining. That is what it will be shown and it will be done. But if you want me to show you how to configure the report, I'm sorry, I cannot do that because I'm a purely a functional consultant and I cannot do a technical report.
So you can able to select in WWA, right?
Yeah, WWA is part of functional consultant, right? We have to do that. We have to create that report. Anything else you want to ask, Ravi?
No questions from my side. And how long this training will last?
Sorry?
How much time it is going to take for this training?
See, basically it takes around 60 hours. That's a normal time, normal duration to complete it. But if people are not from the same background, as I told you, it talks about environment, health and safety. If people are not from the same background, then it might take extended hours. Because as a functional consultant, you should understand and appreciate the reason why we are doing it before we proceed further for the activity. So on making you understand the concepts and then showing it and then getting it done entirely depends on how quickly you can grasp or based on the skill set. But normally it takes 60 hours.
And how many successful implementations were there in EHS?
How much?
How many successful implementations?
No, I couldn't get you. Your voice is very low. Can you speak a bit louder if you don't mind?
Yeah. How many successful implementations in EHS? I think it's a quite new module, right?
Yeah. See, at this point of time, there are, I can say, very big implementation, major implementation clients. I can say more than 350 or 400 clients have implemented this EHS tender, which are major clients. I'm not talking about smaller clients, okay? And because of the Kyoto Protocol deadline that is being set by various governments, most of the municipalities are also going for implementing, which are already having SAP to implement as EHNS, SAP EHNS. So the future, the tremendous option means you said the demand and supply that can be done, whether you look into DICE or Indeed or wherever it is, EHS consultants are paid a fortune. So that research can be done and the demand and supply gap is huge. So, at this point of time, I can say 300 to 450 clients are definitely 300 to 400 clients are definitely implemented it. But in future, it will be exponential growth.
I have another doubt also. Like if you take in any other functional consultant like SDR, MFI, so as part of the project implementation program. How many objects they are going to develop, like how many functional specifications they are going to develop, and whereas in EHS, how many functional specifications?
See, that's what I am telling. EHS is entirely a module which depends on the regulation or the country where we are working. So today you start a project this year thinking that within 1 year I will deliver, and you take some objects to develop, say for example 15, 20, 50 objects, and in the middle of time a regulation changes. Then you are forced to change the implementation and include new number of objects. So EHS is not in the, like you say, I have 10 objects or 15 objects or 30 objects to deliver, I will deliver and go. It's not like that. Even when you're signing up also, it will be very tricky. They will always say that during implementation also, if I have a new regulation or new objects, you have to do it. Yes, I'm forced to do it. And it also entirely depends on what modules you are selecting to do it. How many regulations you are following to do it. Where, which countries you are involved to do it. So all this determine how many objects will come into picture. We are not talking about only a process. We are talking about external regulation authorities also who are involved in this.
Classification is a part of, I think there is an event concept called classification.
Yeah, classification, we need to have an understanding of classification system also when we go for EHNS, because without that getting what to say phrases or WWA report is not an easy task. So you need to have a basic understanding of the classification system also.
And outer other two processes will be like.
Sorry?
How many functional consultants, EHS consultants there in the market now?
See, that's a very tricky question, because when you look into the complexity or the magnanimity of a project, definitely you need at least 5 to 6 consultants, but due to the shortage of consultants, even if you find a single consultant to deliver, that's a big achievement for an organization nowadays. A single consultant, a proper EHS consultant who has implemented at least 2 or 3 implementations, if you find them for a project, that's a big achievement. But ideally speaking, you need to have at least 4 to 5 EHS consultants to implement it, because these are all huge implementation. Even though if it is a greenfield implementation, these are very huge. So, but unfortunately, a single consultant is managing the show always.
And coming to the support wise, is it obviously there should be one support consultant should be there, right, after the implementation?
Yeah, support consultant is again a tricky role, where you can even train one of the SD, MM or PP guy, and then you have to do it.
So then it is not required.
It's not required for a core EHS, because we need not make this guy stuck up only for a support role. But yes, if it's upgradation, if it's a rollout kind of thing, you can have the proper EHS guy. Otherwise, you can train any other guy to be involved in the support activities, where the EHS guy can see a top level or high level priority, and then the normal or low level priority can be handled by the other guys. That way we can adjust or develop a new resource also slowly, which most of the organizations are following nowadays.
Yeah, that's all from my side.
Okay, great. Great, Ravi.
And is it, certification is part of easy, or is it, can I go through the certification after this course?
Sorry?
Can I go to the certification after this course?
See, certification, as you know, even if you look into the SAP America or SAP any country, you don't have certification for SAP H&S. Because, as I told you initially, this is a product of TechniData. It's a partner product. It's not a SAP core product, even though, yes, last year SAP has purchased TechniData. So for the next 2 years, we cannot expect a certification from SAP point of view.
And who will give the input to the EHS consultant? Because SAP EHS consultant, he knows about more about SAP, right? So
see, the inputs to the business process owners can be from the environment side. We call him environment engineer. Can be from the health side. We call from occupational health coordinator. Can be a safety officer also. Can be a QHSC manager. these people are the main core business process owners from a company's point of view.
So as a core SAP EHS consultant, it's not required to know the industry background, right? Either he can able to work on construction.
No, that's what I was telling. Industry background, at least if a few things he's knowing, that would be better. Because if he's a layman for regulations or something like that, it will really take time for him to pick up. At least he should know some of the regulation. Because basically you work with a business process owner who is a very senior person or a old person, we can say. So definitely he also expects some kind of knowledge from the industry point of view for EHS consultant.
So all kind of industries can implement EHS, right?
Not exactly all kind of industries. Even if a single industry is known also, that would be fun, because we can always say that my experience is with this industry, but it would always be great for me to learn an additional industry which I can get it from you. So definitely I would be honored to work with you. We can always put it in that way. So that fellow will be very happy to guide us through his industry. That won't be a problem at all, because each industry has its own regulation, but at least if you have understanding about one industry, that will suffice.
No, it's part of this EHS implementation. So almost all, every industry can implement this EHS model.
Any industry which is having employees can implement it, as I'm telling. Even IT industry also can implement, because if you see a fire extinguisher, smoke detector, a water sprinkler and all, these are part of EHS regulations. When you are driving your car, you are having some certifications like stage 1, stage 2 certifications, power star ratings for electrical equipment, appliances we are buying. These are all related to EHS only.
So can you maintain any business rules in this one? Is there any business rules concept? Business rules concept?
Is there any?
Business rules.
Okay.
Rules concept there in EHS?
Yeah, definitely roles concept is there. That's what I'm telling.
Rules.
We are having a different roles. The roles can be a safety side role, or it can be from a health side role, or it can be from a any other role.
I'm saying that rule, R-U-L-E.
R-U-L-E,
rule.
Okay, rule. There are expert rules when you're generating a report. There are expert rules when you are generating a report, but this will be mainly done by when you are generating a report using a WW kind of thing. That can be done. Yeah. Naveen, are you there?
Hello Ram, I'm there, okay.
Hello Naveen, are you there?
Yeah, Ram, I'm... Hello?
Okay.
Okay. Ravi, any more queries, Ravi?
Yeah, if...
No, not from my side.
Okay, can you leave Ravi? Because
yeah.
Ram will speak through him phone or anything else, okay?
Okay,
why
not, sure. Yes, thanks, sir. Thank you.
Hello, Kumar.